Good morning, students. So in last class we did some sums regarding square roots by using prime factorization method. So in this class we will do some sums regarding prime factorization method. First one, find square of a number 720 to be multiplied to get a perfect square. So this is the question. Find the square root of a number 720 to be multiplied to get a perfect square. 720 is a given number. 720 is a number. 720, is it a perfect square first? It is not a perfect square. Why? It is not a square of any number. That's why it is not a perfect square number. That's why we want to convert this number into perfect square. How we will get that? With this number we can multiply it by some number, it will become a perfect square. That multiplied number we want to get. That multiplied number is how much? It will become perfect square. Perfect square. Okay, this is a given number. So by using prime factorization, by using prime factorization 720 we want to convert it into prime numbers, multiplication of a prime numbers. So what is the first step? We want to divide this number with smallest prime number. What is the smallest prime number? 2. 2 is the smallest prime number. That's why we want to divide with 2. 2, 3 is a 6. Here 1 is a remainder. It will become 12. 2, 6 is a 12. Now 0. 2, 0. Next. 2, 1 is a 2. Next. 1 is a remainder. It will become a 16. Means 2, 8 is a 16. And next 0. Next. 2, 9 is a 18. Next 0. Next. 2, 4 is a 8. Next. 1 is a remainder. It will become a 10. 2, 5 is a 10. Now, here 5 is there, it is not, whenever unit place is a 5, it is not divisible by 2. That's why we want to move another prime number. So here 4, 5, it is divisible by 3, 3 1s are 3, here 1 is the remainder 15, 3, 5 is a 15, next, again, 3, 5 is a 15, next, 5, 1s are 5, 5, 1s are 5. So at last we will get a 1 as a remainder, it is a multiple value. Next, so means 720 number, we will write product of these prime numbers, means 2 into, how many 2s? 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. Next 3, how many numbers? 2. 3, 3 into. How many in 5s? Only 1, 5. So 720, it will become perfect square. So that's why we want some pair numbers. So here 2, 2, it is a pair. 2, 2, it is a pair number. It is having a pair. But 5 is not having any pair. 5 is not having any pair. That's why we want to multiply. How? So to get a, it will become a pair. Which number we want to multiply it? Again, it will become, again, this number only 5. Then only the number, it will become a perfect square. Why? It is a pair. It is having some pair numbers. But 5 is not having a pair number. That's why this number, again, we want to multiply only with 5. Not 2, not 3, not any number. If it is multiplied by 2, it is not having a pair. That's why we want to multiply this number with 5, then it will become a perfect square. So therefore to get 720 as a perfect square multiplied by 5 means 720 is multiplied by 5. 720 multiplied by 5 means how much? 500. 52 is 10. 57 is 35 plus 1. 36. Now 3600. So 720 will be converted to which number? 3600. So 720 is not a perfect square. After multiplying with 5, it will become a perfect square. 3600. 3600 is a perfect square of which number? 60. That's why 720 number is multiplied by which number? 5 is the answer. So that's why this number is multiplied by 5. It will become a perfect square. Okay, next question. Next, 6000 should be divided to get a perfect square. So this is the second type of a question. Here find the square root of a number 720 is multiplied to get a perfect square. But here 6000 is a number, to get a perfect square should be divided with some number. Then only it will become a perfect square. Basically 6000 is not a perfect square number. That's why we want to divide this number and then it will become a perfect square. Then what is that number we want to calculate? So 6000, again same method, prime factorization method. So 2 3 is 6, 0 0 0. Next 2 1s are 2, 1 for remainder, 2 5s are 10. Next again 2 zeros. Next 2 7s are 14, 1, 2 5s are 10, 0. Next 2 3s are 6, it will become 15. 2 7s are 14, 1, 2 5s are 10. Next 5 is a remainder, 5 is at unit place. That's why it is not divisible by 2. Next 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 1 remainder 15, 3 5s are 15, 3 5s are 15. Next 5, it is not divisible by 3. That's why 5 2s are 10. 2 remainder, 5 5s are 25. Next 5 5s are 25. Next 5 1s are 5. 5 1s are 5. Means what are the numbers? What are the prime numbers? We'll get 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 2s. 1, 2, 3, 4 into how many 3s? Only 1. And 5s, 3 numbers. 3 numbers. Now, so to get a perfect square, we want to take pair numbers. So now it is a pair. But 3 is not having a pair. It is a pair. But 5 also not having a pair. 5 also not having a pair. Means these two are the extra numbers. These two are the extra numbers. So means, so how much? 3, 5 is 15. If we remove these numbers, remaining numbers having a pair. If I remove these numbers having a pair. That's why 3 into 5, 15 is having an extra term. Then only, so these numbers will be divided. Means these numbers will be divided by 15. Then total number will become a perfect square. Here divided is there. That's why these numbers again divided with 15. Then only it will become a perfect square. Okay. 3 here 5. So therefore 6000 to become perfect square should be divided with what? These numbers have extra numbers. 3 5s should be divided by 15. Then only 6000 will become perfect square. Means 6000 number is divided by 15. So what is the answer? 6000 by 15. 15 ones are 15, 4s are 60, again 2 zeros. Now it will become 400. 400 is a perfect square. Now it is a perfect square. perfect square. So what is this one perfect square? Which number? 20. 20 into 20 is how much? 400. So but 6000 is not a perfect square. That's why we want to divide it by 15. How we get 15 number here? By using a prime factorization method. These three numbers are alone numbers. Means these two don't have any pair numbers. That's why we want to divide 3 5s are 15. Then only it will become a perfect square. Okay, clear? Okay. Next class we will continue with next sums.